we are, I see a difference too. As you can see here, we've got twins. Me and Innocent are twins. And we've got the third guy. So yeah, we're gonna start with our childhood. Just a brief story of our childhood.
All right. Growing up in Soweto, it was a bit interesting for us because what the media was talking about and TV and the news were showing, it was a bit different from what we were experiencing, you know. I mean, personally, when we were young, we were creative. We used to make cars with bricks. We used to walk around and look for places to do our somersaults and
skate.
We used to skate a lot and we used to just have missions, you know. And what the media was showing was a lot different to what our experience was, because our experience was fun, but the media was showing kids that were starving, kids that were studying in bad situations and all of the above, and that wasn't our experience really. I went to a school that was exciting. We did sports, I used to run a lot, and I had a lot of friends. And it was just fun. I never saw any crime and experienced a lot of that. So that influenced a lot of what we do. Yeah.
So basically growing up in a township where
sorry, we need that thing to skip.
Sorry.
Cool. Well, this is the three of us. We were in Senegal, having fun. Yeah.
So basically, our childhood inspired us to see the world differently. And through mentors and people that we learned from, like the aunties that we had from home, the drunk uncle, the dad, they were stylish, and the grandfather was super stylish. We took a lot of that from them, and then we thought we should try and portray our Soweto in a beautiful way and stop the whole thing of people taking photos of kids with snotty nose and all of that. So we thought maybe we should have a different approach in the whole world of blogging or showing our world. So
So basically what we did was we took pictures of Soweto the way in which we saw Soweto. Because in Soweto to us, when we see Soweto, Soweto's our love, you know? Like everything happens. We fell in love there. My first kiss actually was there. And then, you know, so those are the stories we wanted to tell because we grew up there. So we live there instead of having someone who doesn't even live there who comes there and starts taking pictures of things we are not familiar with.
Yeah.
So with Soweto, there's just so many things you can learn. And
yeah. And from the things we were learning in Soweto, what was a bit tricky and interesting to us was that the people that were telling the story of our Soweto were people that are not from there. So their angle and view of showing our Soweto was not what we know, you know? So like he said, having our first kiss and playing around with our friends, skating, was what we experienced, you know? And the kids that were dirty and the struggle were not what we experienced.
So as we were saying, like there's wisdom in the streets, because in the streets you can learn just like what Innocent said, from a drunk guy. Because the drunk guy will walk drunk there, and then if you listen to him, it might take a while for him to tell you the exact same thing. But in all of that, there's that serious thing that he's going to say that you can learn from him, you know. So it's nice to give everyone a chance, especially like in Soweto, if you grew up there, you'll know that you don't only have one mother. Like the ladies in this, the lady that stays next door to you is your mother. So the lady on the other street is your mother. So if you do something wrong on the other street, you know your mother's gonna hit you. And when you get home, your mother's gonna help you. Because it's just a whole community of, it's a community of family. Yeah. And that's why there's wisdom in the streets, you know.
And we took a lot of advice and style from that guy, from the old guy like that. And then we decided that there's positive and negative in life. There's a lot of things that are bad, there's a lot of good things that happen. and you choose as a person which thing you want to choose. You know, so we decided that we'll focus in the beauty and the positive of life and the positive side of Soweto instead of the rough side of Soweto, the Zola, the dingy parts of of the slums of Cape Town and whatever. So yeah, we took a positive approach on everything.
To us it was important as well from our experiences growing up, as the quote says. What was interesting is that growing up, they were telling our story consistently, and how they were telling it, it was so negative that we believed it ourselves. Then when we believed the negative they were telling in our story, it became the truth to us. But we grew up to understand that this is not the truth when we looked at our childhood and our experiences realistically. So as the quote says, it's true, you know, you create the world you see, you know, and what we see in Soweto is so much more. And what everyone was documenting was not aspirational at all. So we wanted to have an approach that will give the youth and everyone that's from there hope, and that will remind them of what they've experienced, you know, and that will show them the real world rather than what the media and everyone else is showing in our Soweto.
So we carried on taking pictures all around Soweto, Zola, as in Soweto, to clip down all around Soweto, and then we just realized that this thing is just, it just can't end there. We need to see if we can try to do another place as well, you know. And this is a picture we took in Senegal, when we went to Senegal, and we, you know, that's a guy that stays in Senegal, not Innocent with the six packs, the other guy. He stays in Senegal, you know, that's the shop in which he used to buy his stuff, you know, growing up. Now he's a model in Paris, but that's the shop in which he used to buy his stuff. So he took us all around, and we took shots of places where he grew up in, and we got to understand the place in which he grew up in, the way he saw it, not the way in which we saw it in newspapers and magazines. We're so touched when we went to Senegal because it is a very beautiful country.
So everywhere that we go, we try and look at the place in a beautiful eye. We try and feel like we belong there and not look at it as a tourist. And we always want to tell beautiful stories and show the world how we experience that place.
Well, that's me and Innocent in Senegal as well. So here, as we are doing this thing, we just want to preserve our heritage, because like as we travel around, we notice that like as Africans, we don't embrace our culture, as you know, like we seem to forget about our culture or put it aside because of the Western influence that we get all the time. So as it actually makes me think of a story that I heard of. There was this boy. 11, 10 years old, he first got his trumpet, you know, started playing the trumpet. And he used to listen to records of jazz artists, like your Miles Davis's and your Johnny Coltrane, your John Coltrane. So he used to try and mimic them. He used to play to the sounds, you know, that they're trying to do, play with those sounds all the time, every day. And he got a chance to go to New York. And when he got to New York, he met the guys, you know, he met Miles Davis and all those jazz artists at the time. So as he was playing, they came to him and they asked, why are you trying to play like us while we are trying to be like you? You know, because only he could play that unfiltered African sound through his trumpet, you know. So that made him think, and he got back to, he realized that he should play stuff that he knows, you know, stuff that the world doesn't know. He should be himself, he should be African. And today that guy is Hugh Masekela, you know, he's the biggest jazz artist here ever. So that's the story that, you know, we're trying to share to people, like preserve your culture, hold it, you know, just know what sound you are playing through your trumpet, you know, that's just...
Then we're gonna take you through some of the images we've taken and the stories we're trying to tell. And well, before that, to us it was important to package ourselves as South African youth from Soweto, which is seen negatively, and we present ourselves to the whole world, to show that there's hope in Africa and Soweto and what we are as a youth. And the process we took, the process we take when we take our photos is that we capture the subject and show the rest of the mood and the environment so that you experience more than the cropped photo would show you.
Just looking at this picture, you know, we grew up in families, Christian families, you know, Christian background, very strong Christian background. We actually met in church, like the three of us. So this is a picture of like just never letting go of, you know, the foundation which you've been laid, in which they laid you on, like never letting go of what your parents taught you, you know, as you can see that guy's holding a Bible, you know.
And basically, we were mostly inspired by international blogs. Blogs like Jound and all those things that you see in France and beautiful pictures. So we thought maybe we should try and create our own beautiful world and capture it in a way that the world can want to come and see our world, where we're from, in an interesting way.
We took this shot recently. It was by the shops where we used to buy fat cakes when we were like five. And yeah, God and all of the above.
This shot is just the kids playing, you know, umpampari, the trampoline in English. So this is the fun that we had. You know, like just looking at all these places, it just takes us back. You know, just trying to tell those stories that people don't tell. Like this guy's story, you know, he's a tailor. He's a tailor that does our clothes and our pants. They tailor it, that's why they look so nice.
And it's very affordable.
Yeah. So what we did with this guy was to tell his story, you know, because like most of the time, people like him, like don't get their stories told, you know. And so we decided to tell his story because no one was going to tell it if we didn't. So that's like the whole thing about blog is to tell people stories that people don't, who can't get a chance to get their story told. So whatever.